G'day guys, I'm WattleGaming and welcome back to Days Gone Survival Mode. So last time I think we did some stuff up in Tucker's region. We went and rescued Lisa and sent her down to Lost Lake. And now this part, we've got this ominous warning. The world comes for you. So we're definitely doing that today. I think that's the Lost Lake entrance. I can't remember exactly. So let's go talk to Cope real fast.
Camper's like
St. John. I got a job for you.
Cope.
You want Manny to work on your bike? Only one way that's gonna happen.
I gotta do runs for you. Yeah, I heard you.
I need you to deal with a marauder camp near those burned out shacks along the Cascade Highway. You know where I'm talking about?
Yeah, I know it.
Radio me if you wanna know more.
Okay. That seems like a relatively good thing to do.
Have you been?
Oh, by the way, they added in some new decals into the shop. This one might be more recognizable for people that have played Uncharted. This is actually Sam's decal. I can actually show you this. So in the decal section, if we just go into custom, we have got Uncharted Sam's bike, Uncharted Shoreline's bike, and also like a flashback version, along with like the other ones that I've been doing in the challenge mode series. So that's all good. I'm gonna keep Sam's one on for now.
Be here.
Why the hell not, eh? So I'm just gonna try and advance the plot as much as what I can now.
Cope, I'm heading to that drifter camp along the highway. What else can you tell me?
Men coming. Not much. They followed one of our supply runs. Got a little too close. I sent a man to check him out. He never came back.
Holy shit!
You sent anyone to find him?
Yeah. Man named Deacon St. John. Cope out.
I see you running around.
Shit! Excuse me. No. No. Take that shotgun and shove it up your derriere. Seriously, go away.
No more, no more.
Just shut up. I'm cutting you loose.
What? You're not.
Copeland sent me. Come on, get up.
Oh, my God. Thank you. Thank you.
Come on.
They were following us on a supply run. I didn't know what to do.
Hey, shut up. Can you run?
What? Yeah, yeah.
Well, then run. Go.
Thank you. I'll tell Copeland you saved my life.
Wow, was that it? Was that it? Alright then, I guess we finished that off a lot faster than what I was expecting to. And the best part is, because I've done the challenge mode things now, if we have a look on Deacon's thing right down where his hand is, Deacon, move your hand, you can see all the patches that I've earned from challenge mode. And all of those bring over all the juicy, juicy perks that went along with it. So the best part is like, we might be able to have a more fun time at the game now because I've got extra perks that, like, increase fuel refueling and damage against enemies and bullet penetration. All that nice, sexy stuff that I got out of challenge mode. We're on part 10. I'd say it's more than enough time where we went down the Lost Lake and expanded the story. We can't stay up here forever. I need new loot and new car, like bike parts and new weapons, so.
Gotcha like that.
Oh yeah, I can already see what that patch is doing. The most recent challenge in challenge mode that I did. I don't know if this video will be up before the other one or not, but basically, I got the gold medal on it, and the reward is for the patch that I have a 20% reduction when I hit something, if I'll slow down or not, and I just saw that in action. But let's just get out of here, head back up to Boozer, because he is getting worse. He's turning into a bit of an...
Cope, I found your man.
Is he alive?
Barely. He's heading back to you on foot. I want to send someone.
I'll do that. Thank you, St. John.
They're coming. They're coming. Oh, they're gonna. They won't know. I mean, they're on me.
Sugar? What's going on?
No!
had to get in here.
Whoa.
You stay right there!
Roger, it's me.
Stay there.
It's Deke. Let's just
don't
calm
you come
down.
Any closer. Let's just I will talk. Kill you.
It's all right.
Come on, give me the gun. Give me the gun, buddy.
No,
come on.
I will
come
not! On.
Oh, shit. Oh, Jesus Christ. Boozer, what the fuck?
I heard him. I heard voices.
Oh, shit.
I mean, you heard him, right?
No, I didn't hear shit, Boozer. You got blood poisoning.
I do not.
Yes, you do, Boozer. Just take a look.
I don't need to take a look.
Come on, we gotta get you some help.
Look, I don't need some.
Come on.
Damn it, don't need help. Sorry about that. About trying to blow your head off. I mean, I thought I saw something, you know?
Yeah. We've all seen voices and things in our head, Boozer. It doesn't make them
easy.
Real.
Hey, watch the steps.
I got this. I mean, it was in my head, you know?
Yeah, I know.
Come on, we're getting you some damn help. This has gone on long enough.
I could hear him, Deke. I could hear him, Deke. Footsteps just pounded in my head. Boots.
Just a few more steps.
Just a few more steps, Boozer. Come on, you can do it. Deacon, would you mind walking a little faster, please? This is kind of urgent.
I don't need any help. I can goddamn walk. I can walk.
Okay.
Just get on the bike. It'll be fine. Try not to blow my head off again.
I don't...
Yeah, now come on. Get on, we gotta go.
Wait. What? Where are we going? I don't...
It's just a short ride, Boozer. It'll help clear your head.
Right? Okay. That'd be good. Here, okay.
Yeah, I kinda knew that this is where we were going.
Where are we going? Deke.
Do you remember when we first rode out of Farewell? What that was like?
Yeah. Remember.
The highways were all choked up with cars. There were so many people, all on the move, thinking that if they could only go fast enough, that they'd outrun what was coming.
Yeah.
No one could move fast enough, Boozer. No one saw it coming the way I did. So by the time they said, fuck it, you know, and started walking and then running, it's too late.
Too late.
And I remember watching the freaks, watching them all come, thousands of them. And all those dumb shits just got swallowed up.
Yeah, I remember.
When you see a thing like that, you know it's only a matter of time before it's our turn. Nothing's gonna stop it, Boozer. Not a goddamn thing, but do you know why we keep going?
No.
Because what the hell else are we gonna do?
Yeah.
Lately I've been wondering what's been going on. I've been here before, but I don't remember when. And every time we get to where we're entering, I feel my beliefs and hope surrendering. Because I know that I'll be coming home soon with a soldier's eyes, with a soldier's eyes. And yes, I know that I'll be coming home soon with a soldier's eyes, with a soldier's eyes.
Prettied up before heading in.
Oh, you know. Yeah, I figured I'd Stopped in the lodge, have a few beers, and then just strolled into the infirmary. No, man, I just sick of it.
Yeah. No, I don't care. I'm just fucking with you. Hey, Deke. Mike said he'd kill you if he ever saw you again. And if he said it...
That old man doesn't remember his name half the time.
No.
Hey,
he'll remember.
You gotta stay awake. We're off the open road, but if a freaker wanders by...
Yeah, I know. Mm-hmm. All right. Hey, Deke.
Yeah?
Don't you kill anyone in the camp, okay?
Not gonna kill anyone. You good?
Never better.
What the hell? Let's go back. There's nothing here.
What?
You heard the guy, same as me. Probably some drifter. Not worth dragging me out here. Shit, we're supposed to guard the camp, not wander around jerking off.
Could have been Rippers.
Oh, against the two of us. Really?
We could get him before they...
No. See, that's what we thought, too.
Always need
me and this guy, Addy's brother. We went out on patrol.
Cold as fuck.
You know, not far from here, really. We kept to the shadows. It was night, but the moon was out. And you know Rippers love the night. We heard him coming first. Shrieking like freakers. They were coming straight out of hell. God, that sound. There were maybe four we could see. So we open up on them. They don't even try not to get shot. Thing is, they weren't going down. They just kept running at us. My boy got one of them down, pulled his knife to finish the job. Shit, I should have told him to forget it. Two others
got
right on him, and I fired.
You fired?
Yeah, I killed him. They were tearing him apart like goddamn freakers. I fired and got the hell out of there. So, you go after Rippers, you better have backup.
That's a cool story, man. So, instead of, going in and, pleading and trying to get them to help him, no, we're just gonna go steal it. This is just Deacon's thing right here. If they want to kill us, we'll just, steal from them. It'll be fine. By the way, this lady needs to get the hell out of my way.
A rock.
Yes, a rock. You people are damn smart. You probably need another one. Go on.
Hey.
Yeah, that's right. Go look at your rock and rack off.
Something's here.
Yeah, you people say that a lot. Okay, who else we got here? That guy is...
Is there someone out there?
No. No one's here. No one is absolutely here. You can rack off in that direction.
That was a rock.
Yes, it was. What are you gonna do later? You people are very perceptive, aren't you?
That's what. That girl, Lisa, whatever.
Someone's
new one
out here.
She cries all the damn time. First few days she.
Right, let's just climb up here.
It's her deal.
Okay, we're into the camp.
Shit. Even money?
How the hell are you gonna keep the peace with a bunch of crazy ass lunatics who cut themselves? How could you trust anything like that?
Anything? These are people, not freakers.
That's debatable. Schizo's right. The only thing these assholes understand is force. We sign a peace treaty like we're goddamn UN, we show them we're weak.
That's right, you sit down. Let me dive in over here. And over here. Because you people obviously can't see the man with all the guns on his back sneaking around
what?
Camp.
You see someone?
You see shit, buddy.
Yeah.
What the?
Something's here.
What'd you find?
It's a rock! Shocker! That's right, you go back over there. I'm gonna do a roly-poly.
Who was that?
The men in there, they weren't...
Oh, and you saw nothing. Don't come over here.
Shit. Iron Mike. Schizo. Son of a bitch.
Raymond?
And the men we buried? They were butchered. Butchered. Christ, it took us 3 hours to rake up all the body parts.
Raymond?
It's Carlos, and you know it. We gotta hit him back, or the Rippers are gonna...
Schizo, leave it be. Just leave it be. Hey.
Uh-oh.
You there! Stop!
God damn it, Schizo!
Son of a bitch.
Raymond? Yeah, Schizo is not usually this perceptive. Like, seriously, the boy is blind as a bat. Now, can I, like, do this without getting detected this time?
We gotta hit him back, or the Rippers are gonna...
Schizo, leave it be! Just leave it be!
Alright, we're past the point now. Good.
And what about the next group? And the next? Hell, Carlos is already pushing into Rogue Camp. Camp Pioneer...
There's no proof of that.
Okay, where is everyone else? We can leave these two alone. Okay, go. Rolly. And there we go. It's alright, you didn't people didn't see shit. You saw absolutely no one and nothing. Nothing is ever gonna change that. You people see nothing, right? That's right. Deacon, will you stop grunting when you roll, please?
They're not here. But you can go in and see for yourself.
We'll come back. You know, Addie don't like it, you snooping around in her business.
Hey, you said it. Not me.
I'm not laughing.
Now, there it is. On. I just
come
gotta find a way inside.
Here. I want to talk to those men myself.
Well, let's just hope they're still breathing.
Okay, anybody else around? No? These two are pissing off, and we're all good.
Hey, what's up?
Oh, come on. Don't get detected, Deacon.
That did it.
And just shut that door. And we got ourselves some antibiotics.
Ah, damn it. Hi, Ricky. Hi, Addie. I don't want any trouble, so if you ladies just step aside, I'll show you
my
way out.
No, what the hell are you doing in my infirmary?
Oh, are you gonna shoot me now? Oh, wait. There's a code, right? You can't shoot a woman unless you have to. Well, now you have to.
Ah, shit. Okay, look, why don't you just let me explain?
Check what's in the cooler. What are you, selling narcotics for Tucker now? You know, when you brought me that girl, I thought you had changed. But clearly you haven't.
No, it's not narcotics.
What?
It's antibiotics.
Boozer's sick. He's got blood poisoning. I had no place else to go.
Blood poisoning? What happened?
Does it matter?
I fucked up.
Bring him in. Go and get him. Bring him here.
No, we can't do that.
Yes, we can. Look, I don't care who he is, and I don't care what Iron Mike thinks. When a man is sick, a man is sick. We have to look out for each other. Baby is all we got.
Come on, I'll give you a ride.
Everyone else seems to be pissed at me. Whatever the hell I did.
Which way we headed?
You remember there was a small camp when we first rode into the valley?
Yeah, I remember.
Well, good. That's where he is. Unless he's been eaten by a freaker.
You call this a bike?
It may not be a fancy drifter bike, but it gets the job done. Get on.
So, how's she doing? The girl that I brought in, Lisa. Are you gonna take me to see her?
No.
Oh, God damn it, Ricky. What the hell? Why not?
I can't. She's not here.
Wait, hold on for a second. Where is she?
A few days ago, Schizo assigned her to a scavenge run. She and three others headed over to the rogue camp to look for supplies. They came back without her.
Telling me they left her? They left her out in the shit?
They didn't leave anyone. They said she ran off.
Jesus!
It could have been anything. Wolves, freaks, rippers. Choose your poison.
And what was Schizo thinking, sending her out on a supply run?
Everyone's gotta work, Deke. That's the deal, and you know it.
I don't believe this shit. What? She'd been surviving in Marion Forks for years when I found her.
Yeah, then maybe you should have left her there.
She's got a point there, Deacon.
Who's there? Hey. Get back, don't make me blow your goddamn
Boozer,
head off.
It's me.
No, get back!
Oh. Hey. Hey, it's Ricky. You remember me? I rode with you guys a year ago.
Ricky. Tumalo?
Yeah.
That's Tumalo to Lost Lake?
Yeah. Yeah.
Hold on.
That's right. How are you doing there, Boozer? You doing all right?
Just peachy.
It still didn't give you the right to steal our ship.
Are you kidding me? Look at his arm. What was I supposed to do, huh?
I don't know. Maybe ask. Jesus. Look at you guys, the biker boys. The most badass drifters in this shit, right? And now you come back crawling to Iron Mike. Oh, wait. If you'll let you. Come on, just help me get him back to Addy. Let's go.
Come on, pal.
I still need your help. Ricky.
Yeah, Boozer Ricky.
Oh, come on, big guy, get on.
You're on me, Deke!
Who's on you?
Wait, where are we going?
Addy said she's agreed to take a look at your arm and see what she can do.
What? No. No, you're not taking me to some goddamn camp. I can ride, damn it.
We're not Damn it. Boozer, it's just for a few days. Get some shit for your arm, and then...
No. You know what it's like there, Deke.
No, you're not thinking straight. This isn't the Hot Springs. This is Lost Lake. Iron Mike. Remember him?
Iron Mike? He's gonna get us killed. He said...
That was a long time ago. They built the place up. They got more people.
We're all gonna fucking die.
We'll be long gone before anything like that happens. Camp's got the only dock in 100 miles. Now, Addy, look, she'll take care of it.
Just a couple of days. Yeah, then we ride the hell out of here. Right north, like you said. Get
taking
the hell
fire.
Away from all this.
Yeah. Yeah, we ride north. Leave all this shit behind.
Why does riding north sound like going to Tahiti and Red Dead? Like, seriously, can we stop?
Okay, so... I'm gonna go back and check on him and make sure he's okay.
Coward.
Yeah, you got that right.
Well, how long? And until he can ride, I mean.
You mean how long do you have to be here? Look, we have antibiotics, but it's not enough. If Iron Mike lets you stay, your friend will have a chance.
Well, time for the moment of truth.
So what happened? How'd he burn his arm like that?
We ran into some rippers south of Belknap. Guess they didn't like his tattoos.
Jesus. I've heard about them doing shit like that to themselves, but not to people they're trying to recruit.
Boozer wasn't any goddamn recruit.
Guess Tucker should have made a deal with them like Iron Mike.
Come on, Ricky. He doesn't get it. Carlos isn't gonna honor any deal with Lost Lake. Not for long, anyway. And Mike, he just doesn't see it.
He sees more than you think. You've always had your good side, Deke. You've just been doing your best to kill it.
Ran into a bunch of crazy
assholes. Thanks for the vote of confidence.
Almost naked, all scarred up, like they took a knife to themselves. Joe said they were rippers. A cult over in Iron Butte called Rest in Peace. They worship freaks. You believe that? They worship them. Like they've been raptured into heaven.
You cannot believe a word he is going to say. Addy is soft. Mike, we do not have enough for those that pull their own weight, let alone a goddamn cripple.
He's not a cripple. He can work.
I say we throw them out on their asses.
Mike, that is not who we are.
Jesus. Listen to you. And you? You tired of being Tucker's little bitch, finally?
Raymond, huh? Stop it!
Don't call me that!
I'm pretty tired, all right. All right, see? Enough!
See? You know who the fuck this guy is, and you know what he...
You hold on! And you! You put that shit away.
Mike, Deacon was one that brought me the
I know. And I know what kind of man he is. What he's done. He done any worse than you? Ricky? How about me? We've all been out in this shit, Schizo. We've all done things we're not proud of.
We need another rider.
Oh, now, wait a minute. I just need a few days and some antibiotics. I'll do whatever it takes.
Sure, Mike. Whatever you say, I'm on board.
Walk with me.
Don't
start with me. So you're the one who brought him in.
I didn't bring them in, Schizo. Boozer needed help.
But he broke into the infirmary.
The tackle shop isn't exactly
secure. Ricky told
secure.
Me you stopped running
you
for
were
Tucker.
Supposed to fix that weeks ago.
Sent that little girl here instead.
Oh, so what?
You're I'm sorry I lied to you so before about doing runs for Tucker.
Isn't that your job?
How long you been drifting? You and Bill?
I don't know. Like I said, time gets lost.
If folks don't put down some roots, figure this shit out, grow some food, come next spring, won't be none of us left.
If you give Boozer what he needs, let us hole up here till he can ride. Like I said, I will do whatever you need. I want you to know that as soon as he's patched up, we're gonna put together some gear, we're gonna ride north.
North, huh?
There's a camp up there near Smith Rock. Boozer's never been there. Anyway, got a lot of ghosts down here. It's time we move on.
Fresh start, eh? Yeah, I can respect that. Now go on. Leave me be. I got some thinking to do.
Sure, Mike. Yeah, whatever you say. Just have Ricky radio me if you need something.
And there we go. We've got a lot of trust. We need to get this place up to trust one, like, almost immediately to get some good stuff. Look, there's a new skin. And, ooh. Drifter crossbow. Hold on a second. Drifter crossbow? Does that mean I have a new crossbow, or is that the... Okay, I have no idea what the hell that is. So, this area, Lost Lake, we need to get this up to trust level 1, like, almost immediately, because I'm going to get some new guns, I'm going to get new car parts, not... Freaking car parts. Bike parts. Deacon's bike isn't a car. It's a bike. And this place has a lot of parts for it.
Oh. Hey, I gotta ask you. I heard you riding in last night with Ricky and, who's that guy?
Boozer. His name is William. Or Bell. I've always just called him Boozer. Don't ask why.
Is he gonna be okay? I stopped by to say hi to Addie. He didn't look so good.
Yeah, he's gonna be fine as soon as he's patched up. We're riding north, you got that? So, just drop it, okay?
Deacon, can you stop being, like, a loner, please?
See you later.
I've got, like...
Hey, none of my business,
I've got a couple of ears.
I heard you were back.
Yeah. I'm not interested.
Wait, what? Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Where's the kitchen, by the way? Because I have a piece of bear meat that is worth something like maybe 30 credits. I think it was at Copeland's. Let's see how much it is here.
What? You need something?
You got a problem?
Oh, 31 trust. Look at that. That's done literally nothing to put me up towards the next level.
Is this enough?
All right. Unless I go take out a horde, which I don't really want to do because I can't exactly remember where there is a horde around here. I'd probably say let's just go on with another main mission because we don't really have a lot else to do.
Deacon, hey, is everything okay? What's wrong?
Actually, that's not why I'm here.
Okay.
Came by to see if there's anything you need for the infirmary.
Actually, we're running low on everything. I mean, we could always use more meds, sterile bandages, instruments. Here.
A Liston knife.
Yeah, it was used by doctors in the Civil War to perform operations in the field.
Operations?
Yeah, you know, when they didn't have any anesthesia or laudanum. I wrote down where you might be able to find one. It's the brochure for the visitor center at Sherman's Camp.
Yeah, the plate's crawling with all the freakers. I'll see what I can do.
Yeah, Deacon. Thank you.
Liston knife. Head to Sherman's camp. The place is gonna be crawling.
Well, in one way, this is the way that I'm gonna upgrade the camp. Oh, and it's also a nest infestation area. Oh boy. They've given me such a gem to start with this time.
Hello? Is anyone on this channel?
O'Brien, is that you?
Yes, yeah, it's O'Brien. You still have one of our radios, good. Okay, look, I'm gonna try and help you find out about the woman.
Sarah Whitaker. I put her on your chopper that night.
Yeah, I know, okay, but first, you gotta do something for me.
Wait, what? You need something from me?
Look, there's a digital display on your radio. I'm going to send you a coded message, coordinates. Meet me at that location.
O'Brien, what the hell is this all about?
Just meet me there. There will be Nero soldiers all around me like before. Don't let them see you. O'Brien out.
What in the flipping flying floop is going on?
Just meet me there. There will be Nero soldiers all around me like before. Don't let them see you. O'Brien out.
The bastard killed.
What? There's no more ambassador at this
point. Run away!
The hell, man?
Last.
I'm listening to a message from our good pal O'Brien.
You out there?
Tuck, yeah, I'm here, and I'm guessing you got another job for me. So, okay, I'll stop by. Deacon out.
Wow, what a bunch of rude bastards.
Can't fix this.
Can I fix this?
Let's go.
Oh yeah, that's the other thing I had to do too. I had a skill point, and I've been thinking about this one. I'm gonna put this into survival, and I'm gonna get this. Because now I can carry double my weight in everything. Oi, losers! I've just about had enough of you. I'm down in this frickin' place for 5 goddamn minutes, and I've already been shot and almost frickin', like, clotheslined. Screw you, you frickin' piece of crap. Wow. These people. I'm down here for 5 minutes. And I've already been shot at and almost clotheslined. Peaceful people you have down here, Iron Mike. Peaceful bloody set of people.
Here it is.
Now, as far as what I am aware, there is a horde here. But I don't know if it can actively spawn in this mission, so yeah, let's not find out if that's true. That would be great. Oh, I've upset somebody. Let's make one of these and just whack the crap out of anybody that even comes within a 10-meter radius of me. Get rid of you. Don't you try and dodge me, sir. Okay, I need to, like, hurry up and just start moving. or otherwise I'm gonna die. I'm straight up gonna die, and there's only one way into here, isn't there? Yeah, of course there is. Alright. Well, I said I had to get ears. This is probably the best way I'm gonna get those ears. Anybody else? You're a very angry person, sir. You need some treatment for that. A bat across the face would probably be the first thing I'd give you.
The door's locked.
Oh, no shit. No shit, man. Would you, like, just... There, climb up there. There we go, now we're in.
Finally, Jesus.
There's someone shooting over here as well. There might be some marauders in this area. Hopefully they are.
Down here. Not much left. This place has been picked over clean.
All we need is the Lister knife. Here we go.
Lister knife. This is it. Gotta get it back to Addy.
Lovely, lovely, lovely. Okay, open this up. Really, dude? Can you rack off? You and your freaking girlfriend?
Need that.
I'll tell you what, why we're here, because we've only got to head back to Addy anyway. And plus, if I do this, I'm going to get some camp trust. So I might just quickly just go around and take out the free nests. Or at least the other two that I have to do in here. Because if I do that, that's just more camp trust. That works for me.
Got time to light it up.
Here we go.
Another nest. Let's go.
Be nest number two. Just run my ass off. Now I just need to find out, is there the where the third one is, actually? Is the third one upstairs? No, that's blocked off. Okay, game, where? Oh, hang on. No, there's a window here. Oh, what are you people been doing in here? You guys shat all over the floor and the wall? Goddamn people! If these guys come outside, I will shoot. There we go. Got rid of that. I got a measly amount of trust. Alright, that's great. Alright, I feel like it is time to get out of this place. Because I have just upset the local population. Run, Deacon, run. I think there is a horde here, but I don't know if it can spawn in yet, nor do I want to find out. So I just want to get on my bike and get out of here. That infestation zone didn't even give me that much, which is actually quite disappointing. Alright, Sherman's camp is clean of freakers for the time being. I have a knife, which I gotta go give to Addy. Hopefully this will give me, like, a bunch of XP for this camp, because I would actually like to go start buying some upgrades for the bike. I feel like the bike needs it at this point.
Need a couple.
Hey.
Oh, here's that knife you were looking for.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, no problem.
And there we go. And really? You can't give me any more than like 300 trust, really? Alright, oh, now we've got some missions to do. So we need to search Rogue Camp for Lisa. And we also need to meet with O'Brien because it's time to meet with O'Brien again. And she has a bloody job for me. Okay, that job can wait until I have to go visit Rockwife again, because I am not driving up all the way up there just for that and then driving all the way down. That feels a little bit stupid. This is where I think I can leave this video off for today, as I get a new skill point. Oh boy. Oh, a second burst of adrenaline would really, really be nice. What else can I do? Frickin' melee, I haven't even touched. Because I just don't use melee at the moment. It's ranged and that because I don't want to get close. Ability to reload a ranged weapon while sprinting. That one is just a necessity. Alright, this is where I can leave this video off. We've done some progress. It was very cutscene heavy this part, but we're down here in Lost Lake, and that's what matters. Next time, we're probably going to head out to Rogue Camp to look for Lisa, and also go see O'Brien. We're just going to start, like, pushing on with the main missions, and this place will get upgraded somewhere along the line. So drop a like, leave a comment, and I will see you all in the next video.